Hello everyone, today we are going to analyze a three-hinged parabolic arch. Before analyzing, let us read the question one time. A three-hinged parabolic arched rib ACB with supports at different levels, as shown in the figure, has horizontal span of 15 meter, the hinge at the crown C being 6 meter horizontally and 2 meter vertically above it. You can see the figure. The span of the arch is given, that is 15 meter. The crown C is 6 meter from the point A and it is 2 meter vertically above the point A. Calculate the difference between level of the supports at A and B. So we have to calculate the difference in the levels. For that we have to calculate this distance. The arch carries uniformly distributed load of 24 kN per meter horizontally from A to C. You can see that from A to C, this arch carries a UDL 24 kN per meter. Calculate the horizontal thrust of the arch and position and amount of maximum negative bending moment. In this arch, first let us calculate the difference between the level of the supports at A and B. In this arch, we are having two risers and two lengths. For the left side, the length is 6 meter. For the right side, the length is 9 meter. For the left side, the rise is given, that is 2 meter. But for the right side, the rise is not given in the question. So we have to calculate the rise on the right side. We can apply the formula L1 by L2 is equal to root of H1 by H2. Here L1 is equal to 6 meter and L2 is equal to 9 meter. H1 is equal to 2 meter. H2 we have to calculate. We can apply all the values inside the formula. Now we can take square and both the sides. 6 square we will get 36. 9 square we will get 81. Root of 2 by H2 whole square we will get 2 by H2. In this way, we can calculate H2, that is 4.5 meter. Now we can calculate the difference between level of the supports at A and B. We need this distance. So H2 minus H1. H2 is equal to 4.5 meter and H1 is equal to 2 meter. We can apply. Finally, we are getting 2.5 meter. Now let us calculate the horizontal thrust of the arch. To find out the horizontal thrust of the arch, we have to form two equations. We can take moment about C from the point A, because in the point C the moment is zero since it is hinged. By taking moment about C from A, we will make one equation. Again, we can take moment about C from the point B. Now we get another equation, so we can form two equations and find out the horizontal thrust and the vertical reactions. First, let us take moment about C from A. In this case, we are moving towards right hand side. Clockwise will be positive, anti-clockwise will be negative. The vertical reaction VA is acting towards the point C in the clockwise direction, so it will be positive. And the distance is 6 meter, so 6VA. The UDL 24 kN per meter is acting towards the point C in the anti-clockwise direction, so it will be negative. When the UDL comes, we have to multiply with the distance and distance by 2, so 6 into 6 by 2. The horizontal thrust is acting towards the point C in the anti-clockwise direction, so it will be negative, and the height is 2 meter, so H into 2. Finally, we are making one equation. Let us divide the equation by 6. When we divide, we are making one new equation. Let us keep the equation as number 1. Now, let us take moment about C from the point B. In this case, I am moving towards left hand side. Clockwise will be negative, anti-clockwise will be positive. The vertical reaction at B is acting towards the point C in the anti-clockwise direction, so it will be positive and the distance is 9 meter, so 9 VB. The horizontal thrust is acting towards the point C in the clockwise direction, so it will be negative and the height is 4.5 meter. Finally, we are making one equation. Let us keep the equation as number 2. In this arch, let us calculate the total load. In this arch, only one load is acting, that is UDL 24 kN per meter. It is acting for the distance of 6 meter. So total load is equal to 24 into 6. We will get 144 kN. We know that the summation of upward forces is equal to the summation of downward forces. In this arch, we are having two upward forces, VA and VB. So VA plus VB is equal to 144. VB is equal to 144 minus VA. Let us apply the value of VB in the equation number 2. After applying, we are making one equation. Let us divide the equation by 9. So we are getting a new equation. Let us keep the equation as number 3. Now let us add the equation number 1 and equation number 3. VA minus VA, it will be 0. When we add these two values, we will get this. 72 minus 144, we will get minus 72. Finally, we are getting the horizontal thrust, H is equal to 86.4 kN. Now, let us apply the value of H in the equation number 1. After applying, we are getting VA is equal to 100.8 kN. We have already formed this equation. Now, we can easily calculate VB by applying the value of VA. Finally, we are getting VB is equal to 43.2 kN. In this question, we have been asked to find out the maximum negative bending moment. The maximum negative bending moment will be occurring on the right side of the arch. Because on the right side of the arch, we are not having any load. Also, the vertical reaction is very less. So, the maximum negative bending moment will be occurring on the right side of the arch. But we do not know where it occurs. So, we are making one section randomly on the right side of the arch. In this section, we are having the horizontal distance x. We have to calculate the moment in this section. For calculating the moment, we need to find the height. The formula for height is here, yx is equal to 4hx into l minus x by l square. We are calculating the bending moment on the right side of the arch. In the right side of the arch, we are having length of 9 meter, but we need the total length. So we have to multiply 9 into 2. When we do that, we are getting 18 meter. We can apply 18 meter inside the formula. So we are getting 0.055 into 18x minus x square. Now let us calculate movement about the section. We are calculating the movement about the section from the point B. In this case, we are moving left hand side. Clockwise will be negative, anticlockwise will be positive. The vertical reaction in the point B is acting towards the section in the anticlockwise direction, so it will be positive, and the distance is x. The horizontal thrust is acting towards the section in the clockwise direction, so it will be negative. For the height, we can apply this value. After that, we can make some simplifications. Finally, for mx, we are getting this. To find out the distance, there is one condition. For maximum bending moment, dmx by dx is equal to 0. That means when we differentiate mx with respect to x, we will get a 0. Let us differentiate. For x, it will be 1, so minus 43.2. For x square, it will be 2x. 2 into 4.8, we will get 9.6. Finally, we are getting x is equal to 4.5 meter. Now, we can apply the value of x in this equation. Finally, we are getting the maximum negative bending moment is equal to minus 97.2 kN meter. Now, we are going to end this session. Thank you for watching this video.